You'll never know if you don't go. You'll never shine if you don't glow. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid.
And all that glitters is gold.
Only shooting stars break the mold. It's a cool place, and they say it gets colder. You're bundled up now, wait till you get older. But the media men beg to differ, judging by the hole in the satellite picture. The ice we skate.
Hello everybody, this is Overboy, and I'm going to be doing my top 5 favorite female killers in horror movies. This is for the Thrill Me Thursday that me and some of the guys in the Horror Enthusiast 101 do. Every Thursday we do a top 5 list, and this This week's list is 5 favorite female killers. And everything. So, this was actually a pretty good list, idea and everything. It took me a while to think of 5 that I wanted to do and everything. So, I'm gonna go ahead and get started. Number 5 is Tiffany from Bride of Chucky. I liked her a whole lot in this movie. I thought she was really awesome. She was just as crazy, if not more crazy, than Chucky was. And I thought that she was a really good match. I think Jennifer Tilly did a great job playing her and doing her voice and everything. I like Tiffany best in this movie, though. I didn't care too much for her in Sea of Chucky. And she was okay in Cult, but she just wasn't in it very much. But I did really like her in Bride of Chucky and everything. She just really awesome killer, and I love some of her kill scenes, especially when she throws that bottle up at the mirror in the hotel room. That was just a really awesome kill and everything. So Tiffany is number 5, and number 4 is Mrs. Loomis from Scream 2, played by Laurie Metcalf. She's one of my other favorite horror villains, and she's out of the Scream sequels, she's probably my favorite villain out of the 3 Scream sequels and everything. I think that Laurie Metcalf did a really great job playing her. She was really crazy and everything, and she was really, just did a really, really good job playing the character and everything. I like how in the first movie we think that she doesn't care about Billy because the way he talks about her, and we find out that she did, and she wants revenge on Sydney because of everything that happened and everything. So I think they did a good job on that. So Mrs. Loomis is number 4, and number 3 is Baby from House of a Thousand Corpses and The Devil's Rejects. I just absolutely love this character. She's just so over the top crazy and everything. I think Sherry Moon Zombie does a really great job playing her. I know a lot of people don't like her or Rob Zombie's movies, but I absolutely love those two. They're my favorite Rob Zombie movies, and she's one of my favorite characters in them. I can't wait to see 3 from Hell next month. I'm super excited about getting to see it because it's I just can't wait to see that, and I can't wait to see her playing the character again. She's awesome as Baby Firefly. So she's number 3, and number 2 is Carrie. Now, I think this is kind of becoming a tradition for these top 5 lists, because each of my top 5 lists have had the movie Carrie on here and everything. I guess it just shows how much I love this movie. I really love Carrie. I love when she finally loses it and gets her revenge at the end of the movie. One of the most satisfying endings to a movie to me, getting to see her rage and everything, and get revenge on all of the people that made her life miserable and everything. And System Spacek just did such a great job playing her. I think Chloe Grace Moretz was okay in the remake, and the girl who played her in the TV remake was okay, but none of them were as good as System Spacek. She was perfect in the role and everything. Even though she didn't really look like Carrie was described in the book, she still fit the part really well, and they did a really good job making her she did a really good job making Carrie feel like a misfit and stuff like that. Just really awesome killer and everything. She's one of those that you can't help but root for, because she really has a good reason for doing what she does and everything. So she's number two. And my number one favorite female horror movie killer is Pamela Voorhees. I've always loved Mrs. Voorhees. I thought she was really, really great character. The actress that plays her, Betsy Palmer, I think is her name. She does a wonderful, wonderful job playing her and everything. She's one of my favorite horror movie villains and everything. And she was the first female horror movie killer I remember seeing and everything. I really, really liked her in this movie and everything. And I'd like to give a couple of shout outs or honorable mentions to Annie Wilkes from Misery. She did kill at least one or two people, but she didn't have like a big kill count, so that's the main reason why I didn't put her on there, because I think she's more psychotic and a lot better than Tiffany. But personally, I put her lower because of her not having as much of a kill count. And then the other one, I cannot remember the character's name, but the villain from the movie Fingerprints. She was really crazy character and everything. And so I'd like to give those two a shout out, because I the one from Fingerprints, I can't remember her name to save my life. And to be honest, she's great and everything, but she's not as good as these other characters. And then Annie Wilkes, like I said, the only reason she didn't make the list is because of not having a very big kill count. But anyway, let me know in the comments who your favorite female horror movie killer is. And hope you enjoyed this video, and have a good day, everybody.
Mock! Yeah! Ing! Yeah! Bird! Yeah! 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 Mockingbird! Don't everybody have you heard?
Have you heard?
She's gonna buy me a mockingbird! And if that mockingbird don't sing, she's gonna buy me a diamond ring! And if that diamond ring don't